have lost their life in that accident which took place because of people burning an effigy of Ravana on a railway track, your first reaction to that breaking news?
You see, we've been discussing about the pollution, now we're discussing about something which is very, very tragic. It's very uncommon. I have never heard that this is happening. You know, we have been seeing railway accidents because of lapses, because of unmanned barriers, or because of sometimes days failing or something like that. But never this is seen that the Ravana effigy, maybe it was actually a remote area of Amritsar somewhere nearby where the villagers had an access, or there may be the barrier, that there was no barrier, they were burning it, and there was an immediate brake which was pulled by the driver, and something that happened. You see, at this point of time, the immediate attention is not so easy. You see, depending upon the personnel available, whether depending upon the doctors available, where it has happened, whether it's a remote area or the village or a nearby hospital is available or not, most of the time the local people, they try to help and get the people salvaged to go to the nearest hospital or whatever available. You see, such casualties require trauma expert people who can be really, first of all, the people have to be removed from the bogies, and then they have to be shifted, or most of the people, they lose their life because of either immediate cardiac arrest or something like head injury, or sometimes a loss of blood while they are being transported from the local area to the hospital, because you know the doctors are not available. Even the paramedical staff is very difficult to get in such a local, unless you are very lucky that the accident has happened inside the city area where the access to the hospitals is very good.
Right.
So I would say that 50 casualties have already been reported. Many must have been injured, who must be waiting for the treatment. And much more than that, and we have to be sure that how the doctors will be available. You see, I feel that there has to be a permanent solution for such problems, because I'm not talking about the railway protection or what, I'm talking about the availability of the medical staff. I think every 5 kilometers there should be a small hospital or somewhere. I mean, we have been facing such problems, and you can actually save lives by getting immediate medical attention.
Mm-hmm.
If there were immediate medical attention available, then of course out of 50, maybe you can save more, 10 more. And every life is precious, and you know, the family, considering the family, being a child or whatever. So we have to have every 5 kilometers, and that has my suggestion earlier to the railway board also, that every 5 kilometers there should be a small medical unit who should be there. Meaning we're not doing anything.
Right.
But considering the number of, we are having railways problems, so we should, I think, not only for casualties, but also for some time there will be patient.
Right.
Along. And then of course you have to be
absolutely. So every life is precious, and of course as rescue and relief operations are on, now we are trying to get updates from the ground as well. My colleague Uday Pratap Singh is also joining us from the newsroom. Uday, take it forward from here. Tell us all the details which you have on this breaking story.